Good morning, class 8. Welcome back to your biology classroom once again after your first term exam. Hope all of you done well in the exam. So let's start the second chapter as per your second term syllabus, reproduction in plants. So let's start the chapter. Reproduction is the process by which living organism reproduce more organism of their own kind. So what is the process? Reproduction is a biological process by which living organism produce more organism of their own kind. The ability of an organism to produce offspring is of one the most basic features of life. Reproduction is essential for the continuity and survival of species. So by the process of reproduction, any organism are able to continue and survive of the particular species. In this chapter, you will learn about various types of reproduction and development in plants. Types of reproduction. There are two basic modes of reproduction, asexual and sexual. So first of all, you will learn this line. Reproduction are basically two types, asexual reproduction and sexual reproduction. Asexual reproduction. The production of offspring from a single parent without the fusion of sex cell or gametes is known as asexual reproduction. So what is asexual reproduction? Asexual means without sexual fusion. मतलब जहां पे parent cell से directly offspring पैदा हो रहा है, मतलब gamete cell के अंदर कोई fusion नहीं हो रहा है, मतलब proper fertilization नहीं होता है. Directly single parent produce offspring without fusion of sex cell. That is known as asexual reproduction. This form of reproduction involves only one organism. Since only one parent is involved, the offspring have exactly the same features as the parents. So whereas asexual reproduction takes place, the offsprings are directly, matlab pura ka pura parent cell ka जेरोक्स कॉपी होता है, मतलब एग्जैक्टली दे पोजेस द सेम फीचर्स एज देयर पेरेंट. नेक्स्ट, सेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन. इन दिस टाइप ऑफ रिप्रोडक्शन टू ऑर्गेनिजम्स ऑफ द सेम स्पीसीज फीमेल एंड मेल आर इन्वॉल्व. ईच सेक्स कंट्रीब्यूट्स रिप्रोडक्टिव सेक्स सेल्स और गैमेट्स. द मेल ऑर्गेनिज्म प्रोड्यूस गैमेट्स कॉल्ड स्पर्म, while the female produce gametes called eggs or ova. So whereas male gametes are also known as sperms and female gametes are also known as eggs or ova or ovum. The offspring is produced by the fusion of sperm and an ovum. Thus sexual reproduction can be defined as the production of offspring due to fusion of male and female sex cell. The offspring produced has a mix of features of both parents and is not identical to their parent. Matlab, in case of sexual reproduction, whereas parent cells, I mean male and female gamete fused together and form offspring. That's why offspring possess different identical characters. They are not exactly identical to their parent. मतलब offspring का खुद का कोई changes हो सकता है. ऐसा नहीं, they are totally xerox copy होगा अपना parents का. Next, asexual reproduction. Asexual reproduction is more common in lower forms of life, such as bacteria, fungi and algae. So basically, asexual reproduction is found in the lower class organism like bacteria, fungi and algae. The following different types of asexual reproduction are seen. First of all, binary fission and multiple fission. The pronunciation is not binary. Binary fission and multiple fission. Binary means two and fission means splitting. So, what is the meaning of binary fission? Bi means two, fission means splitting. Thus, binary fission is the simple division of unicellular organism into two small daughter cells of roughly equal size. So, what is the process? In case of binary fission, parent cell, which is unicellular organism, that split into two equal size daughter cell. Each daughter cell grows into adult individual, which divides again, and this type of reproduction is observed in bacteria and Euglena. So example is mast. So binary fission means two splitting, whereas parent cell is unicellular and it divided into two equal size daughter cell, whereas daughter cell matlab after growing into adult individual, it is also divides again and to produce new offspring. So in this way, the binary fission is processed. So basically, this fission is observed in bacteria and Euglena. Sometimes during unfavorable condition, some organisms develop a thick protective covering around themselves called cyst. Iske niche daag lagana. So during unfavorable condition, some organism develop a thick protective covering or layer around themselves. It is called cyst. Inside the cyst, the cell divides repeatedly to produce many daughter cells. When the condition get favorable, the cyst breaks open, releasing the daughter cell. Each daughter cell grows into a new organism. This is called multiple fission. So what is multiple fission? Please try to understand. Matlab aap unfavorable condition mein organism develop a thick protective layer around themselves, that is cyst. So inside the cyst, the cell divide many times and produce many daughter cells. And after getting the favorable condition, cyst breaks up and releasing the daughter cells. So each daughter cell grows into new individual organism. This process is also known as multiple fission. Thus, in multiple fission, many individuals are formed by splitting of single parent cell. Such reproduction is seen in unicellular algae such as Chlorella and Chlamydomonas. So examples are here. Multiple fission basically observed in unicellular algae. They are Chlorella and Chlamydomonas. So hope all of you understood what is the difference between binary fission and multiple fission. So in case of binary fission, single parent cells divided into equal size of two daughter cells and they possess identical character to their parent cell. Whereas in case of unfavorable condition, the organism develop a thick layer around themselves and inside the cyst, they divide in many times and produce many daughter cells. And after getting the favorable condition, the cyst breaks up and the daughter cell just coming out from the cyst and they grows into individual organism. This process is also known as multiple fission. So student, you will learn the difference between binary fission and multiple fission as well as the example. So hope all of you understood what I've discussed in this video. So for today, up to this portion.